Hi, welcome all of you on platform of Fairpedia Education, and you are watching the series of post-gate counseling videos in which hum log aapko batate hain where you can apply, what are the different departments where you can apply after gate, you have got the gate score, and kya opportunities hai wahan pe, and how you have to well prepare for those kind of opportunities. So in that particular series, I am discussing with you aerospace program in IISc Bangalore. You know, Jagjit sir has already uploaded one video on IISc Bangalore. Admissions are open. In that line, I am now discussing with you one of the department. Dekho, whenever you are to apply, this is the best time. Abhi gate exam aapka ho gaya hai, ya kuch students ka bhi ho jayega is weekend. So this is the best time when you can prepare for your applications, like which department you have to apply, how you have to apply in that department, preparation of that department, knowing the professors in that department. So aapko Arthas department, 8 to 10 departments in all the IITs, IISCs, etc. you should know, including NITI Bombay and PSUs. You should know where you have to apply as per your score, right? That guidance obviously your PDA team is also going to give you, and you have to apply that. Now I am taking one of the department, which is aerospace department, and that is quite good department in all IITs. Aerospace se achhi options nikalti hain, jobs bhi achhi lagti hain. In organizations like Boeing, Airbus, private sector ke organizations hain jo placement ke liye aate hain, aur bhi bahut si नए स्टार्टअप्स हैं जो प्लेसमेंट के लिए आते हैं, और बहुत सी कंपनीज हैं. सो दैट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ, एंड इन सम आईआईटीज इसरो आल्सो कम्स फॉर द प्लेसमेंट, सो यू कैन गेट अपॉर्चुनिटीज देयर. आईसी एज यू नो इज द प्रीमियम इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर हायर एजुकेशन, और आईसी का एरोस्पेस डिपार्टमेंट इज रियली गुड. तो आईसी एज इन द वीडियो जगजीत सर मस्ट हैव टोल्ड यू, आईसी यू कैन आफ्टर बीटेक गो फॉर एमटेक, you can go for M.Tech research, which is called MS also, and you can go for PhD. So, these three courses are eligible. Hain. Now, kaun kaun si branches ke students ja sakte hain? That is very, very important. So, listen that carefully. Aerospace mein sabse jyada jo students jaate hain, wo aerospace B.Tech wale students and mechanical wale students jaate hain. Aerospace B.Tech and mechanical, followed by civil, electronics, electrical, chemical. Listen again carefully. Which branch student go in aerospace masters, aerospace engineering B.Tech, mechanical engineering B.Tech, then civil engineering B.Tech, then chemical engineering B.Tech, then electronics and electrical. Now you must have written your gate with these branches. Suppose there is a student who is production engineering background or instrumentation engineering background, then he must have written the gate exam with प्रोडक्शन वाला मैकेनिकल के साथ, इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन वाला इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स या इलेक्ट्रिकल के साथ. तो इफ यू हैव डन दैट, यू विल गेट इनटू एरोस्पेस डिपार्टमेंट, बिकॉज़ एरोस्पेस में देयर इज अ स्ट्रक्चर, सिविल इंजीनियर कैन गो एरोडायनामिक्स या प्रोपल्शन, मैकेनिकल कैन गो केमिकल कैन गो, एंड देन देयर इज अ कंट्रोल एंड फ्लाइट कंट्रोल एटसेट्रा, सो दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इलेक्ट्रिकल पीपल कैन गो, सो दे आर डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट्स. अब आपको अलग अलग डिपार्टमेंट्स में एमएस और पीएचडी अगर आपको अप्लाई करना है, तो प्रोफेसर्स का नॉलेज होना जरूरी है कि विच प्रोफेसर आर वर्किंग इन विच डोमेन एंड हाउ टू गो फॉर दैट. लेट मी गिव यू लिटिल ब्रीफ अबाउट दिस डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एरोस्पेस इन आईआईसी बेंगलोर. तो सबसे पहले आपको, वेन एवर यू आर टू फाइंड सम डिपार्टमेंट, यू आर टू गो इन टू अकेडमिक्स. देर आर डिविजन, देर आर डिपार्टमेंट, सो यू आर टू गो इन टू द डिपार्टमेंट फॉर दैट. सो नॉट वी गो इन टू डिपार्टमेंट फर्स्ट. Let's see when we go to department. So bear with me, internet speed is little lesser here, so you need to bear with me for that particular thing. So what we've done is we have gone into academics, and then we have to enter into departments. Fine. Okay. So as you know, these are now the divisions or departments will open. You can go division, you can go departments. Let me first find out the departments also. I'll show you little later, but this division also will take you to the same place. Let me see if I can show you the departments. Okay, now let me open department here. Okay, now we need to find out the Department of Aerospace. Can you see Aerospace Department somewhere? We are not seeing Aerospace Department anywhere. Aerospace Department actually comes under Division of Mechanical Sciences. So even if you go to Division of Mechanical Sciences, you will find this Aerospace Department there. Now under the Division of Mechanical Sciences, you will find all these departments. That means Aerospace Engineering is part of that, Atmospheric and Oceanic Sciences, Center of Earth Sciences, Advanced Mechanics of Materials. So you know, majority of the departments you can think of applying. Even Civil and Mechanical Engineering is kept under this particular division. So IIC Bangalore has made some kind of divisions and that department. Anyhow, under Mechanical Sciences, Mechanical Engineering, Civil Engineering, Chemical Engineering, they have kept. We are interested in Aerospace Engineering, and in some IITs you will find Aerospace is a different department. It is not under Mechanical Division. It is direct department only. Now I go to Aerospace Engineering of IIC Bangalore. Now let's see, I want to find out what people are doing Aerospace Engineering, what are the various department, everything I want to know. So you need to little explore this particular department, you know. So let me go to people first and let's see what are the various faculties doing in this particular department. So I go to people. Okay, we get it. So you know, you get all the professors here. You will start getting various professors and faculty and students also, but we are interested in various faculties of this particular department. Okay, now you know, in Aerospace Department IIC Bangalore, they have kept filter by designation, filter by research area. When you put a filter on research area, you get these research area. So aerodynamics, structures, propulsions, control and guidance. Let me tell you, these are structures is a typical for civil engineers. Aerodynamics are for mechanical engineers, chemical engineers also, mechanical engineers, civil engineers also. Propulsion is for mechanical engineers, chemical engineers. Control and guidance is a specialization for electronics and electrical. I'm not saying that aerodynamics when you cannot have electronics, electrical people, there are there. But I'm saying typical when you choose one of the research area in aerospace, then if you're a mechanical engineering student, or for that matter production engineering student, go for aerodynamics, go for propulsion if you can think of going that. Even automobile engineer who has written paper with the mechanical, they can go into propulsion. If you're civil engineers, think of structures and aerodynamics. If you're chemical, think of propulsion. If you're electronics, electrical, think of control and guidance, that is our research areas. Now when I go for let's say aerodynamics by this department, then I will get the professors who are working in aerodynamics domain. Now you know, aerodynamics may which branch people are working, then what you need to do, as I told you, right now you have sufficient time to explore and find out domain for you. And those of you who are interested to pursue MS and PhD from IIC, they must find out the professor and the research area under whom you want to pursue your research further. That is what you can do. So I go to each professor and I need to find out what is the domain of each professor. So let's say I go to Arnab, Professor Arnab, and find out what he has done. The moment you see his education, you will find that this professor is from mechanical engineering background. So those students who are from mechanical engineering background, they can think of professor in mechanical engineering. And then you will find something more about this professor, where he has worked and what are the research interests, computational aeroacoustics, linear and nonlinear stability theories, wave dynamics, combustion and heat transfer. So suppose you want to join aerospace engineering in IIC Bangalore and you are good in combustion, internal combustion, thermal science, heat transfer, those are your favorite domains. You can further find out what research area he is working in. Now for this particular professor, there will be publications and projects and research areas. You can one by one press and find out what he is into, what he is working, and you need to read it. The moment you read it, you will get something out of it, that what domain he is working, what are the various areas in which he is working, you need to go through. You will only understand 5% of the things, not more than that. Only 5% things you will understand in which domain he is working. You need to go step by step into these particular domains of his expertise. You can think of his publications, and you know, on the basis of the publications, you can get little idea about his work also. Let me see his publications, which you can go forward, in which you can work forward. So he's working into supersonic buried nozzle jet. He's working into and he's working into parabolized stability equation models, large scale jet mixing noise, computational modeling and experiment of natural convection for a Titan Montego sphere. I don't know what is this. Finite wavelength scattering. I mean, the moment you will be going through his research papers, only 5% things you will understand, but sometime there will be some paper which you will understand, let's say, and you will feel like, okay, I want to go further on this. Just copy it and paste it on Google and you may get abstract. The moment you read abstract, you get some idea on the basis of that abstract in which domain he's working. Computational modeling and experimental analysis. Swirling jet kya hota hai and vortex breakdown kya hota hai. The moment, suppose this paper you are referring, transient energy growth of a swirling jet with vortex breakdown, then you know you need to Google out these words. What is a swirling jet? The moment you put what is swirling jet, first is you Google this entire paper and you will get the abstract. So little idea you will get. Then you put this word swirling jet hota kya hai. And the moment you get swirling jet, then you know, internal combustion engine mein you people must have studied the kind of swirl, kind of turbulence in internal combustion engine, which is used for fuel mixing. CI engine, diesel engine mein fuel is injected and then the air, compressed air mix with the injected fuel and the swirl is created, that is well directed turbulence of the air. So maybe you get that particular concept for a proper combustion. And then vortex breakdown, how to break down vortex, maybe some idea you get. For BTech student who wants to pursue research in higher domain, it is sufficient for us to know that you know little bit, I mean 5 to 10%, that is sufficient. So if you take this paper and you go into the interview well prepared, professor, this is what I've done, then this serves, actually the purpose serves. You need not to know much about this, right? So compressible swirling pipe flow with the density stratification, you know, it looks like that you don't know on the names. When you see the name of publications, it feels like you don't know anything. But when you go into detail, you will get some idea of this. So on internet, you will find all these things over there. Okay, now suppose we want to go further. I go back and I want to find out some more professors now. Let's see. Now, let me find out some another professor who is working to particular domain, like Professor Suhasini. Let's say she is working to some domain. Okay, so what is the background? She has done civil engineering, right? She is the graduate from IIT Kharagpur and she has done civil engineering. Now, as I told you that if you are from civil engineering background, then you find out some professor who is from civil engineering, because his work or her work will be suitable to your work. And then she has done master's in structures and then PhD in mechanical engineering. So that is a kind of profile she has. And then research areas are mechanics of composite materials. As I told you, this material science is also interdisciplinary domain where civil engineers, mechanical engineers can all work together. So she is working into mechanics of composite material. If you want to see her publications, what work she is working into, you can refer her publications also, right? Matrix crack evolution in multi-directional composite laminate considering thickness effect. Or experimental investigation of delamination during drilling of composite structures. Looks like she is now into more mechanical domain than civil domain. So from there you will get some idea, and if you want to work in composite domain in aerospace, you can work in the composite domain also. Let's go back and find some more professors, which domain they're doing. I tell you, this exercise will look like boring in the beginning, but this is present is the best time before GATE result is declared for self-exploration and identification of the domain, and think of where you are to apply, because I told you many times What is very important is not to get a gate score, but to convert that gate score into selection. And those of you who will put equal effort now, they can convert that. I go into different domains now, let's say not aerodynamics. I go into now controls, let us say this. And I get some more professors here. Let's see what they are working into. Some professors are common, but let's see what their professors are into. Right. So Professor Ashwini, let's see what is his graduation. Okay, now I got professor from electrical engineering background. As I told you that aerospace mein you can get in aerospace masters through mechanical, chemical, civil, electrical, these domains you can go, and obviously aerospace also. Then after BTEC in electrical engineering, he has done masters in aerospace engineering and PhD also in aerospace engineering. And let us see what are the publications for electrical guy where he should go. So these are some of the papers he has published, and from there you may get some idea in which domain you want to work. Unmanned aircraft system conflict resolution using return to course maneuver. I don't know what is this all about. So these are the some papers recent past he has done. Okay, now this is on existence and synthesis of smooth four parameter logistic paths inside annular passages. Log polynomial velocity profile for vertical landing. So I don't know what is this all about. Unmanned aerial vehicles pe he has done some work. So point to ray framework for generating smooth parallel parking maneuver. Generalized time optical impact angle constraint interception of moving targets. So you will keep on you will keep on seeing these papers, and our mentors, I mean Europedia's mentors of particular branch like electrical engineering branch, if you discuss with him, they will tell you, okay, this is the domain in which this is required and this is how you can move forward. So that was his work of the professor. Let's go back and find some more professors, what domain they are working. Okay, so let's find out some another professor and his domain. Okay, okay, this professor has not mentioned in which domain he has done his BTEC, but you see the research area, structural mechanics, vibration and noise control, smart structures. You know, there is a term called smart structure. So those of you who are good in mechanical vibration, they say mechanical vibration is our favorite domain, we want to work in that, or noise control, smart materials, smart structure, sorry. So they can think of working in this domain. So let's see what are the publications. Dynamic responses of human body during aircraft seat ejection. Okay, experimental investigation of unsteady flow in transonic uni-stage axial compressor. Okay, acceleration response at different body segments. These are some of the papers. Human response characteristic to impact conditions. Okay, so he is actually working into a vibration domain. So vibration control is also very very important domain in automobile along with aerospace. So whatever domain you choose in such a way that future may you can work in R&D division of aerospace also, as well as automobiles also, because automobile also vibration control is a very very important domain. So this professor is working into this particular domain. Let's go back and find out some more areas for us. Let's see. Okay, now I choose, let us say I go for now filter, not control, but I go for, let us say, aerodynamics propulsion structures. Let us say I want to go for structures now. Okay, now let me find out Professor Naik, what domain he's working into. Okay, his BTEC he has done, not mentioned which domain, but these are the soil mechanics. Can you tell me the background of this professor BTEC? Soil mechanics is civil engineering, right? He must have done graduation in civil engineering, optimization techniques, FEM, finite element method, nano composite, failure mechanics, whenever we ask you, know that which specialization area you want to work in, you should be very precise, because you need to prepare for that. For example, if you say, sir, I want to work in a domain of failure mechanics, so failure mechanics is a research area, and her IIT, mein, every IIT, every IIC must be having some research work going on in failure analysis. So choose one domain for you, because master's is specialization. You need to choose one domain for you, go into that, collect some research papers, collect some information, 5-6 pages, make a file, go into interviews. If you go with that preparation, selection probability is very high. That is what our entire team is going to help you in that. But how to identify the research area for you, you should be well prepared. That is why we are uploading all these videos for your information, because once you call me and if I say what is your research area, which domain you want to work, you people are not very clear in that. So I want that you should have done some homework before we interact with you, so that proper basically effort should be put in the proper direction. Again, if you go to the publication of this professor, he must have published some papers in these directions. Okay, now experimental investigation on the effect of carbon nanotubes. You know, carbon nanotubes are very, very important research area, on mechanical properties of epoxy resin composites. So carbon nanotubes, epoxy resin composites, these are some research basically topics or terms which you should be aware about. Mechanical properties of single wall carbon nanotubes. So he has worked in carbon nanotubes. Suppose you get some idea about carbon nanotubes and all, composites and all, then you can say my research area is, sir, carbon nanotubes. I want to work in that particular direction. Okay, let's go back and find some more professor where they are working. Okay, a common professor you can find. So let me go to propulsion. I think we have not gone so far. Let's see now, Professor Shiva Kumar. Let's find out his work. Okay, this professor has done BTech in aeronautical engineering also. So I think this completes our entire circle. BTech should be in aerospace, aeronautics, aeronautical. BTech can be in mechanical, BTech can be in civil, it can be in electrical, it can be in electronics. So these BTech, I mean, you should have written gate with this. If my BTech is instrumentation, sir, can I apply? I think you should have BTech gate with electronics. Production, can I apply? Industrial, can I apply? If you're written the gate in mechanical, then you can apply, fine. So let's see what this professor is into. His research areas, I think he has mentioned atomization of liquid jets and sheets, engine sprays, biofuel sprays, interaction of liquid droplet with solid surface, wetting behavior of hydrophobic and super hydrophobic solid surfaces. And if you see his publications, also you will get some idea. Experimental study on the equilibrium shape of water drop impacted on groove textured surface. Okay, now jet fuel drop on heated stainless steel surface. Maximum spreading of liquid drop impacting on groove texture surfaces. You know, these kind of research work will be used in many companies, you know, oil companies. Why chemical engineers are pursue aerospace masters? Because these domains are common for chemical engineers, because you are dealing with the oil, chemical, you know, paints and all, even paint industry. So paint industry, oil sector, entire open, automobile sector is open, and aerospace direction is open. So sir, as a chemical engineer, where can I apply for masters? Maybe as chemical engineer, you can apply in oil sector. You can apply in this paint companies, oil paint companies, or different paint companies. You can apply in aerospace domains. You can apply in automobile domains. So this particular domains are common for us. This is what the work for this professor is all about. I think now I have made my point clear when I discuss with you that how to identify the professor and their work. So this was all about aerospace engineering in IIC Bangalore. Forms are out. Those of you who have really good BTech percentage, let's say 80% plus, and they are thinking of getting, let's say, more than 50 marks, 50 marks, they can start their process for MS and PhD courses. Certainly they will get call, but the moment they get call, they should clear some exams, some interviews, and the most important part will be they are to prepare some file for with them, and once you have prepared file for aerospace in IIT Bangalore, in all IITs, IIT Madras, IIT Bombay, you can go with the same preparation. If your gate score is really good, you can think of going for M.Tech also. So sir, should I go for M.Tech research and PhD? Yes, if your gate is not that good, let's say 50 to 60 if you are thinking of, but B.Tech percentage is really cool, that is 80% plus as of now, even 75% plus can go. I'm talking about the general category people. Then you start your process immediately without any delay, because you need to prepare for that. Same activity you have to do for different departments. We'll keep on coming with different departments. Just follow this process. As of now, you have sufficient time, and we will meet for post-gate activities. Thank you.